Hey guys, this is Dr. Sangeeta and welcome back to another lecture of Dental Pathshala. In today's video, we are going to talk about obturation. BMT is very important and doing a root canal treatment because we want all the bacteria, all the debris out. But obturation, if we fail to do obturation, inadequate obturation is the most frequent cause of the failure of root canal treatment. So it is important that we obturate till we get the tug back, till the apical seal. So tug back is when we get a seal up till the apex, when we get a seal up to the cemento-dentinal junction, up till our minor constriction, so where the obturation should supposed to end. So we should get a tight apical seal or the fluid free seal to prevent the percolation of the oral fluids into the periapical area. So while achieving, so while giving, go doing a good obturation, we will get a good root canal treatment, and therefore root canal treatment is going to be successful. So let's talk about the obturation today. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon. That way you get a notification as soon as I release a video lecture. So today's topic is the obturation. Now obturation, after filing the instrumented root canal, this obturation is the final step in root canal treatment. So after the biomechanical cleaning and shaping of the canal, after the BMP, we have to obturate. We have to fill these empty canals with some material so that we prevent the infection again. So we are doing this root canal treatment. We are doing this obturation to finish off this root canal treatment. And root canal treatment or obturation should end 0.5 to 1 millimeter from the radiographic apex. And if you remember the Wien's classification we have talked about, this is for the normal case scenario. If there is a bone resorption, then we have to end it by 1.5 millimeter. And if when there is a bone as well as the root resorption, then we have to end by 2 millimeters. So basically we are obturating the root canal. The canal which we have emptied, the canal which is free, empty, free of bacteria, the canal which is dry now, we have to fill it with some material. And we have to fill it with that kind of material which is non-toxic, which is not giving any adverse reaction to the patient, any pain to the patient, and also which is providing such a seal that it is preventing the infection or the bacteria invasion as well. So according to the American Association of Endodontists, obturation is the method used to fill a seal, cleaned and shaped root. So basically it is a method which is used to seal a cleaned canal. And using a root canal sealer, we are using such a material that which we are dipping in the root canal sealer, and we are filling the root canal, the core of the root canal. Basically, we are filling the whole of the root canal. The core of the root canal means basically we are filling almost all of the root canal. So, what is the purpose or what is the objective of obturation? It is basically to achieve a three-dimensional tight seal of the root canal. So there should not be any bacterial contamination. We have to provide such a seal that there should be no contamination and to prevent the bacterial micro leakage. So there should not be any bacterial micro leakage and to replace this empty root canal space with the inert filling material. We should put such an inert filling material to prevent the recurrent infection so that the infection should not come in. And the criteria for obturation is, see, first of all, BMP properly should be done before doing. So the first criteria is canal should be dry with no weeping of the fluids, and there should not be any discharge, there should not be any bleeding, there should not be any pain, and patient should come to you without any sensitivity to percussion. So there should not be any pain, or the tooth should not be sensitive to percussion also, and tooth should not be associated with any periapical radiolucency. And you do the obturation after and only after you do an optimal cleaning and shaping of the canal. So after a proper cleaning and shaping is done, then and only then you should proceed with the bio obturation. So now you know that when should we obturate? We should obturate when the tooth is asymptomatic, when there is a negative culture, see, if we culture the root canal, then it should be negative. There should not be any bacterial contamination. The canal should be dry, and there should be lack of periapical sensitivity. That means if we do thunder and percussion, it should not pain. And according to Grossman, this root canal filling material, it should be easy to introduce into the canal. We should not put so much of struggle with inputting the obturating material into the canal, and it should provide a good seal. It should not shrink. After we insert it, it should not shrink. Otherwise, there will be a lack of periapical seal. It should not stain the tooth also, which is very important, and it should be bacteriostatic. It should prevent the bacterial contamination, and also it should not irritate the periapical tissues, because otherwise there will be periapical lesion, periapical radiolucency. And in case if bacteria has contaminated, then it should be easily retrievable. That means it should be easy to remove the material. Also, the material should be such that if we want to remove the material, it should come out. It should be sterile and sterilizable. If we want, we should be able to sterilize also. And the most important thing is the root canal filling material, it should be radio opaque. Because if it is not radio opaque, then how are we going to check the length of the obturation? How are we going to check to see till what length we have obturated? So it should be radio opaque. It should come as a white thing in the root canal in radiograph. And also there was a previous myth or conception that was about the hermetic seal. This hermetic seal was a seal which was against, this is a myth or misconception, that we are providing a seal which is against the escape or the entry of the air, basically an airtight seal. While putting this obturation, it should be an airtight, which is a myth or conception which is not used nowadays. So what are the materials which we are going to use it? We are going to use the GP, which is our gutta percha, and also we can also use some solid or the metallic core materials like silver point, stainless steel, gold, titanium, and also some cements are used. If you remember, obturation we have already covered in the pedo. So in pedo we have used obturating material as zinc oxide, eugenol, and also we have used the MTA we have also used, and also we have used, if you remember, we have used Vitapex, Metapex. So all these materials we have used. So the cement can also be used, like hydrone, like calcium oxide, like MTA, calcium phosphate, and gutta percha, of course, it can be used. So guys, gutta percha is the most commonest material which we use for obturating, and it has been used as a material for obturating for more than 100 years. We are using this material for obturation of the root canal since 100 years. And this gutta percha was originally obtained as a dried juice from the Brazilian tree. There is a tree named as Balata, and once we dry and squeeze the juice out of this tree, we get gutta percha. So basically, gutta percha is a resin, and it has these many forms. First of all, talking about the beta form, which we use as a solid form at 42 to 44 degrees centigrade. This is in a solid form. So beta form is used for when we use the solid cold form, cold compression and all lateral condensation if we use, then this is the form which we use. Alpha phase is when we heat to little bit, and when the gutta percha temperature is 56 to 64 degrees Celsius. From 42 to 44 degrees Celsius, when we heat little bit heat gutta percha, then it comes to a semi-solid state, which is the alpha state, which is more pliable, which is more tacky stage, in which we use the warm condensation, the warm method. If we use, then this is the alpha phase, which we use for gutta percha. And once we heat little bit more to the gutta percha, then it comes to the melted state. Then we cannot use this state. So this is the amorphous state. So basically we are using for root canal filling material two forms, beta form as well as the alpha form. Now this gutta percha is composed of, gutta percha is not only composed of the gutta percha, actually gutta percha is composed of gutta percha, which is 20%, and zinc oxide, which is most of the ingredient. So this is, if they ask you in the viva, then what is the main principal ingredient of gutta percha? It is not the gutta percha, it is the zinc oxide. So it is used as a filler. And we also put heavy material because we want radio opacity. We want it to be clear in the X-ray. So for the radio opacity, we are adding bismuth sulfate 11%. And also for the flowability, so that it can go into the lateral canals, it can go into the accessory canals. Basically, it can go into the curved canals. not the lateral and accessory. It is very difficult to put in the lateral and accessory canals, but to curvy canal. Suppose if the canal is little bit curved, right, and you want gutta percha to come and reach in the curved canal. So for that, we add waxes and resins 3% for the plasticity of the gutta percha. This material have been in use since many years. And the advantage of gutta percha is that this is inert, dimensionally stable, non-allergic, bacterial, antibacterial, non-stain, radio opaque, compactable. We can compact it because we'll be pressing, putting pressures. And once we are talking about techniques, then you will come to know what I'm talking about. We compact the gutta percha so that it tightly fits and binds to the root canal. And we soften, because we are softening and heating it so that it can go into the fine canal. So this gutta percha can be softened by heating, and it can be softened by organic solvent also. So chemically activated gutta percha, we are going to talk again in the techniques of gutta percha. Then there is a gutta percha in which we dip the gutta percha in either the chloroform and all, and then we put it in the canal. So this is also diluted or softened by the organic solvent, and this is removable. So that if we want to do re-root canal treatment, that also can be done. But there are again certain disadvantages of gutta percha, that it doesn't adhere to the tooth. So we have to put sealers along with it so that it binds to the tooth surface and it cannot be stretched, and it doesn't give basically strength to the tooth. So it get brittle over the time. So weak hota jata hai time ke sath. Iske kuch drawbacks bhi hain. Isliye silver point आए थे 1930 में टू यूज द सिल्वर पॉइंट्स इन द नैरो कैनाल, एंड ऑल्सो स्टेनलेस स्टील फाइल्स केम, देन टाइटेनियम पॉइंट केम, एंड देन एपिफेनी विद रेजिलियन केम, विच वॉज अ सॉफ्ट रेजिन विच लुक लाइक द गटा पर्चा बट इट बाउंस टू द डेंटिन. So this epiphany with resilion has a great advantages over the gutta percha, which was featured by Oral Health in December 2003. It used to provide a seal. It used to bind. It binds to the dentine, so it provides an immediate coronal seal to the root canal also, and it was easily retrievable. So this is all about the material used for gutta percha. Let's talk about the techniques and some armamentarium which we use for obturation. So there are two kind of spreaders. If we talk about the spreader, hand spreader and the finger spreader. Now finger spreader come in different sizes, as our white, red, white, yellow, red, blue, green, black, right? So like that, paper point also come in the same sequence: white, yellow, red, blue, green, black. So there are two kind of spreaders: the finger spreaders and the hand spreaders. Finger spreaders, they provide a good tactile sensation, and they are less likely to induce fracture in the root. So also there are spreaders which come in the nickel titanium. Earlier it was used to come in the stainless steel, but nowadays we have spreaders coming in the nickel titanium also, and they provide more flexibility. They are actually more flexible, and they reduces the stress, and they can go deep inside. Paper points we use also, they come in the same, they also come in the same size and the same sequence. So it is white, yellow, red and blue, green, black. So like that they also come, right? So they are used to dry the canal after the irrigation. And let's talk about the techniques for obturation. So guys, we have cold lateral compression technique and warm compaction technique. In that we have vertical and lateral thermoplasticized GP injection, carrier based GP. In that we have thermofilled, thermoplasticized and simply filled sectional obturation. And then max pedon thermomechanical compaction and chemically plasticized GP. So in a cold lateral compression, first of all a master cone is fit into the canal and provided with an apical seal, and then later on with the help of finger spreader, this master cone is pushed and accessory cones are placed, accessory GPs are placed. Suppose this is a big GP, okay, and it has provided an apical seal. Now with the help of a spreader, this GP is pushed at one side, and then accessory cones are placed in the space which is created by the spreader. So like that, accessory cones are placed with the help of spreader like that, and then they are cut. So this is the cold lateral compaction technique. So cold, we are laterally placing the GP and we are placing the cold GP. GP is not heated in this, that is why it is the cold lateral compaction. So guys, warm vertical compaction is first of all in the root canal. Master or apical, a master GP selected. So this is our master GP file. First of all, it should be as the apical foramen for the vertical worm compaction, it should be as narrow as possible because we are going to heat it. So we don't want this GP to overflow. So this is our master GP. Now this master cone or master file is actually a plugger is heated and a pressure is applied from the upper coronal part to the in the vertical direction to soften this GP. So this GP will go and flow into this area. So it will be like this. So this is our worm vertical compaction. And worm lateral is when the accessory cones are placed, and then this process is repeated with the help of heat plugger. So this is the worm lateral compaction. Thermoplasticized GP is basically, it is a pressure apparatus and it runs on the electrically heated syringe. So there is a syringe which is electrically heated and the range of the syringe is 18 to 25 gauge size. And this is actually the degree of heat is regulated by the extrusion of the GP according to the size of the needle. So this GP is syringes electrically, it is heated and then it is the GP is put into the canal. Now the next one is our carrier based GP. See, till now we have used the beta form of GP and now we'll be using from the thermophile we use alpha form of GP. If you remember the alpha form, now this is a little bit more flexible and if this GP is heated then it becomes more flexible, and this carrier thermophile plasticized technique is actually it is a carrier which is gutta percha obturating system is there. So this it contains a plastic core carrier, and this core carrier has, so basically this is a carrier like our amalgam carrier, right? So a carrier which carries alpha form of gutta percha, and this is used along with the heating device. So the heating device heats it and then we fill this with the help of a carrier. Now the next one is our simply filled sectional obturation. In this is also carrier system because this is the category under the carrier based system. Carrier based system GP have a machine attached with this. So this is a carrier. A carrier has come and the gutta percha obturating system is used along with the light speed rotary instruments. So we are using light speed, basically according to the diameter of the master file, this has an apical a plug of the GP which performs on the cold sectional obturation. So after the application of sealants onto the canal and then after that this carrier based system has actually instrument in which the handle is rotating in the counterclockwise direction 3 to 4 times, and this 3 to 4 times counterclockwise rotation is providing a seal. So it is revolving and GP is going, and that's how it is providing a seal in the coronal as well as in the apical part. Now this can be used either with the lateral compaction technique or the thermoplasticized GP. So it can be either the beta form can be used, the cold technique, and also the alpha technique, or the thermoplasticized GP can also be used along with this technique. And in the Max Pedden thermomechanical compaction, basically an instrument is attached which is similar to the H file. So instrument has reverse fluid if we compare with the H file, and it is attached with the slow contra-angle handpiece, basically a slow speed handpiece, basically not the aerator, our micromotor. So it is attached to the micromotor with a speed of 8000 to 10000 rpm which creates the heat. Now this compactor forces the softened GP apically as well as laterally. So this is the Max Pedden thermomechanical compaction. Then we have chemically plasticized GP. In this we are chemically dissolve the GP, we are dissolving in the chemical solvents, like if we talked about the chloroform or xylol or eucalyptol. So these are the chemical solvents which soften this GP in this chemical solvents and then put it into the canal, in the fine and tortuous canal, in which no other method we can use, we use this chemically plasticized GP. So these are about the techniques of obturation. The cold lateral technique is when we are placing the lateral or accessory cones of GP into the canal along with the master file. Then vertical compaction is we are placing one master file and then with the help of heated pluggers we are putting pressure. So we are heating the pluggers and we are putting pressure, heating the plugger and putting pressure. Only one file we are using for vertical. For lateral we are using the accessory cones file. And Max Pedder and carrier based are basically are the carriers. They have this whole instrument or machine attached to them. So they have the thermophile or simply sectional obturation. So these are about the techniques of obturation. And if we use the vertical condensation, so vertical warm compaction, if we use, we are putting pressure with the help of plugger. So there are high chances that we may risk the root fracture. So there may be a vertical root fracture because of this high pressure, which is coming at the apical area. So it should not be used. This technique should not be used. And therefore, there was introduction of so many techniques. So we are going to discuss few of these techniques in detail in the upcoming videos. And if you have enjoyed these videos, then like it, share it, subscribe it, and I'll see you soon.